So hi guys, in this video I'm going to talk about resolution. So what is resolution? Basically, when there are given sets of statements and from that statements we need to derive some result, then resolution is used. Before going to talk about resolution, or you can also say for converting statements into a result, first order logic statements need to convert it into CNF form, or you can also say these clause, whichever the clause are given, these clause are needed to be converted in the CNF form, or also called as conjunctive normal form. So basically, for converting first order logic to CNF form, basically there are 6 steps involved in this process. First step is eliminate all implication and biconditional connectives. Suppose there is any given clause, and in that clause we have either implication or we have bicondition, then we need to remove these implication and bicondition into a more CNF form, or you can say in conjunctive normal form. Here P and Q are two given predicate logic statements. What can be two predicate logic statements? First, like for example, P can be if it rains I will become happy. So it is one clause and Q is another clause. So in first step we are going to eliminate all implication and biconditional connectives. How we are going to do this? Suppose P implies Q is given, then we can write this P implies Q as negation of P or Q. And suppose if P biconditional Q is given, then we can write this as negation of P or Q and negation of Q or P. So this was the first step, eliminate all implication and biconditional connectives. Now moving to the second step. In first step we have removed all the implication and biconditional symbols. Now when we have removed implication and biconditional symbols, we have seen that negotiation symbols was present in front. So in step 2, move all negotiation into immediate precede. This means, for example, any statement is given, all Indians love football. Then for such type of statements, for all Indians love football. So in this part, move all negotiation into immediate precede. In this, what we do? Suppose these were the two quantifier, one universal quantifier and second existential quantifier. And suppose in front of universal quantifier we see a negotiation symbol, then we move this negotiation symbol after the quantifier. So when we do this process, the universal quantifier is going to change with the existential quantifier, and the statement can be existential x negation of fx. Now if in front of existential quantifier negation is given, then what we are going to do, we will put the universal quantifier, then negation of fx. So when this process is, this step is applied when negation is present in front of quantifiers. See, in this both the case, in front of quantifiers negotiation was present, and when negotiation is present in front of quantifier, then we move the negotiation to the precede. Now coming to the third step, that is rename variable if necessary. Suppose you are solving any given clause, then if there is a requirement of renaming that variable, you can do it in this step. Now coming to the fourth step, that is the main step, that is scolemized by replacing all existential quantified variable with scoleman function. So basically, how do we do this scolemization function? Suppose, for example, it is given for all x, fx, or for some x, for some y, ky. This type of function is given. Then how we will scolemize this function? Scolemization is done by replacing all the existential quantifier variable with a scoleman function. See, this was our existential quantifier. So what we will do, we will write for all x, fx, or in place of this, because this is our existential quantifier. So we are going to replace existential quantifier with variable of scoleman function. This was the variable of existential quantifier. For some y, the function is ky. Then we are going to write it as k, and this variable, this y variable, we are going to replace with a scoleman function. We can say, you can write any scoleman function, means just like for a name of a variable we write x, y, z. So similarly, for writing scoleman function in place of variable, you can write any function like k, g, k. You can write this also. Or suppose the statement is existential quantifier k function x, and we need to scolemize this function. Then what we will do? We will remove this existential quantifier. We will remove this existential quantifier with a function. Means in f, we are going to write another function. It can be like kx or so on. So when we do this scolemize function, whenever we see an existential quantifier, then we remove this existential quantifier variables with scoleman function. Now coming into the next step, that is step 5, we put all the quantifiers left of the expression. After removing the or replacing the existential quantifiers, all the universal quantifiers will be left. So in this step, we will put all the quantifier to the left of the expression. In the step 6, we will drop all the universal quantifier and conjunctives. Suppose any statement is given, or suppose this was our function, after removing or replacing existential quantifier, this was our expression for all x, k, gx. Now how we are going to remove this? We will drop this universal quantifier and we will write this as k, gx. Thank you.